Hello everyone, and welcome to The Divine Comic Geek. My name is Josh, and today I wanted to do a review of these two lightsabers that I got from Zerka Corp. As you can see, right here we have their first EcoPixel. Their ZeoPixel, since it's Zerka. I wanted to kind of go over some of the features of these two sabers. So this is their ZeoPixel one, which is like their Zerka Corp NeoPixel lightsaber. And this one here below it is their training saber. So I pretty much have them assembled together with the retainer screws to basically keep them in place. And I basically wanted to just do a compare and a contrast between their lighting. So, well, with the light, so you can see how bright they can get. So first I'm gonna do the ZeoPixel one. This is the ZeoPixel. Where the training saber would normally glow this red color. Let me. Versus the ZeoPixel one, which is this very guardian blue type Jedi color. This is the ZeoPixel lit up and light, completely bright. And what I really like is it pretty much comes from the base of the saber all the way to the top, the blade. It's pretty responsive. If I twist my wrist, then it pretty much collapses back to the base in terms of the lighting. And now we're gonna try the training one. It's important to note that this training saber does not come with the scabbard. That was a separate piece I had to order separately. If you watched my last video, I talked more about that as well, about how it kind of took a while for it to arrive. I didn't really do a video of it arriving, but it pretty much came about 4 days after the initial saber. So that's something to keep in mind if you order from this company. It's kind of an instantaneous all at once type thing rather than saying zzz, it kind of says zzz. As far as the motion response when I swing the blade, about the same as the other one, so that's pretty cool. They all, for the most part, come with these little lightsaber cover tech wheels. That's what they're called, the cover tech wheels. Now I'm going to be doing a comparison in terms of the brightness and the dark. So this one is the ZeoPixel. So as you can see, it's extremely bright. And I'm gonna turn this one off for now just because it's extremely bright. And this one is the training saber. Also your RGB base lit, so if you get that too. So as you can see, they're both pretty bright. Now this is both of them. So as you can see, both of these sabers are pretty cool in their own right. What's cool about the RGB training saber compared to the ZeoPixel saber is the training saber can actually take a hit. I know a lot of companies say EcoPixel and some NeoPixels and ZeoPixels can handle a lot of like heavy dueling, but if you want my opinion on it, really, I definitely think RGB base lit sabers can handle more. Actually, my very first lightsaber that is also an RGB, and it's my favorite to date because I only have three so far. I got these two both at the same time, but honestly, this one, which is my first one, this is an RGB saber and I got it from Crimson Dawn. But definitely something to keep in mind just because they have a lot of sabers. This is my second lightsaber company I've ordered from. I've ordered from Rebel Sabers, like some parts I needed for my sabers from Rebel Sabers. I ordered lightsabers, obviously, from Zerka Corp. I've ordered a stand from Crimson Dawn and a stand from Zerka Corp. And then I've ordered a lightsaber from Crimson Dawn as well. So that's something to keep in mind. Another thing that I would recommend getting at some point, it's not necessary per se, but if you want to protect the electronics in particular in your NeoPixel lightsaber, I definitely recommend getting one of these. These are like, they basically protect the inside of your saber hilt from any dust, debris, damage, and or wear and tear. They're called saber plugs or hilt plugs. Whichever you prefer, saber plugs is what most people are calling them, I believe. But yeah, they have some for RGB, which is what I'm using for my Crimson Dawn one. And they basically just pop in from the top, slide in, and there you go. The training saber by comparison, which is this one in front, it's not as heavy to hold because it doesn't have electronics all inside of the base, like the LEDs, and it doesn't have any LEDs or any electronics whatsoever inside of the actual saber, which is why it's so light and I can swing this around easy. And even though it kind of like wiggles around, it's still tight enough in there where I know it's not gonna fly out, it's not loose, and it's not gonna damage it as excessively as with this. So I mean, keep that in mind as well. But definitely, like I would say, beginner friendly wise, this training saber from Zerka is pretty good. But you can also get an RGB from Crimson Dawn if you prefer, or Rebel Sabers, or any other saber shop. Those are the three that I've ordered from. Zerka was probably the one I was most worried about. Rebel Sabers has a pretty good reputation, but they do take quite a bit of time with shipping. And then Crimson Dawn, I was actually impressed to get this literally within a week, maybe a week and a half after ordering. All a matter of preference. But yeah, if you like this video, make sure you like, comment, share, and make sure to hit the subscribe button, as it will help the algorithm. And if you have any other videos you want me to do, maybe some saber spinning videos, because I've done a few practice spins with these sabers, and honestly, I enjoy them. But yeah, just let me know what you think, and let me know if you want to see more content like this. All right, take care.